Friends, in this part of our thermodynamics discussion, we will see isothermal and adiabatic processes. An isothermal process is the one which occurs at constant temperature, that is, change in temperature during the process is zero. Even though the system accepts certain amount of heat from the surroundings, its temperature remains constant, but it can do certain amount of work. So, as the temperature is constant, we may say the internal energy change is zero, or the internal energy remains constant, and hence enthalpy. So, according to first law, we will reach that as the change in internal energy is zero, we can say heat is the negative of work, or work and heat balance each other during an isothermal process. Like this, if the system absorbs a certain amount of heat, an equivalent amount of work is done by the system, and if certain amount of work is done on the system loses equivalent amount of heat. So for every joule of heat absorbed, there will be an equivalent joule of work done by the system, and for every joule of work done on the system, there will be equivalent joule of heat liberated outward from the system. Now coming to adiabatic process. Now we will see the expression of work. We have seen this before, and therefore the heat expression would be like this, related to the ratio of final and initial volumes, because certain amount of work is done. So there is an expansion work, that means a change in volume is expected, and the pressure volume graph, the indicator diagram, gives the amount of work done during the process within the area of the graph, and this will be equivalent to the amount of heat associated in the process. Now moving on to adiabatic process. Adiabatic process is the one which occurs in an isolated chamber. There is no heat transfer, no communication with the surroundings is allowed. So heat is zero during the process, but work can be done. That means a non-zero work exists, and according to the first law, we will reach that the change in internal energy during the process, during the adiabatic process, equals the work. That is, work is done at the expense of internal energy in an adiabatic process. So there is a decrease in internal energy when the work is done by the system. That means a fall in temperature can be noted. Work done by the system, that is, the work is done in the expenditure of kinetic energy of molecules. So a fall in kinetic energy results in a fall in temperature during the adiabatic process. And for an ideal gas, we have discussed that internal energy is independent of volume. It's a function only of temperature. And we have seen this equation, the change in internal energy during a process is related to change in temperature through a constant called heat capacity. And as the internal energy change is reflected in the adiabatic work, we can replace it like this. So adiabatic work is directly proportional to the change in temperature during the adiabatic process. So for a reversible adiabatic expansion, we know the reversible work here is negative of PdV, where the small p is the system pressure of the gas inside the system, and therefore we reach at this conclusion, that is, the adiabatic work, which is given by negative of PdV, equals CV dT, where CV is the heat capacity and dT is the change in temperature as a consequence of the adiabatic work. And a temperature volume graph will look like this. So with that, we closely wind up this isothermal and adiabatic process session, and in the next session we will see Joule-Thomson experiment and Joule-Thomson effect. With that, thank you.